Being productive is not a personality trait. It is a habit. And this is a habit which you too can develop and stick to very easily. Hi guys, my name is Shachi and welcome back to another video. Over the last 2 years, I have been managing a business and a startup. Honestly, this did not leave me with much choice but to be productive. However, this was not something I was born with. I have trained myself to be productive with the help of my mentors, books, blog posts, and tons of trial and error. So in this video, I want to share with you simple things that I have picked up over the years and try and do every day to stay productive. I know the word routine sounds boring, but having a fixed schedule and time for things that need to get done will help you stay more organized and breeze through your day. Instead of just jumping off the bed and starting your day, try and keep aside a few minutes exclusively to yourself every morning. It could be to meditate, to journal, or to just sip a cup of tea, whatever is your thing. The idea is to have a more relaxed and a mindful start to your day so that you can be your productive best. Personally, I like to start my day by filling in my journal, writing a few things that I am grateful for, and reading my affirmations gives me an instant dose of happiness. I also like to take out a few minutes to plan my day and list down everything that needs to get done. Having this task list organized makes me feel like I can take charge of my day and accomplish everything that I want. I feel I'm at my productive best when the environment around me is conducive to work. So usually for me, this is clearing out my workspace, removing any clutter, setting aside a bottle of water, and playing some light music. When all these things are combined, I get into the autopilot mode where my brain knows that it's time to work and to cut out any distractions. So I encourage you to find your environment, your zone, where you can get into this flow state and recreate that for yourself every single day. It might sound dreadful to start your day with the most challenging and difficult task, but hear me out. If you have to do the task anyway, why not do it first when you have more energy and more willpower? Personally, I prefer to get the important things done before noon. This way, the rest of my day is so much easier, and also it gives me enough cushion to handle anything which might come up unexpectedly. I have made a video on how to organize a task list. I will leave a link for that above, so if you're interested, do check that out. This is something which I have started doing recently, and it was after I read this book, that is How to Be a Boss by Lily Singh, aka Superwoman. So in one of the chapters, she talks about scheduling inspiration. Basically, you set aside a few minutes of the day for yourself where you can either read or watch something related to your work, which will inspire you to work better, to do better, and also give you the tools and the knowledge which you might need. So I try and set aside about 15 to 20 minutes every day, usually when I'm having breakfast, to either watch a video related to my work or to watch interviews of people who I admire. Not only do I love this me time, but also seeing the amazing work that other people are doing inspires me to work harder and push more. I don't recommend multitasking at all, with the exception of audiobooks. I want to read more books, and obviously time is a constraint. So audiobooks are a great hack for this. It is such a good way to make use of your time when you're running errands or doing any other mindless work. I love listening to audiobooks when I'm working out alone or I'm knocking off some work around the house. I use the app Audible from Amazon. It's a little on the expensive side, but I get so much use out of it that I totally feel it's worth it. I will leave a link for this app download in the description box below. So Amazon has a free trial for the first 30 days for one book. So if you're interested, you can check out this app and see if it works for you. So guys, these are some of the things that I do to stay productive. It is not necessary that you have to do each and every one of these things, but feel free to pick whatever works for you and work on that. Is there something else that you guys do to stay productive? If yes, please comment below and let me know. If you like this video, do give it a thumbs up and subscribe so that you don't miss out on any content. I'll see you in the next one. Till then, take care and bye.